sofrito, not some Fritos. It's different. It's different. Right now, fresh fish with an Italian twist.
But I love that you're actually adding a little fettuccine in there.
This is one of those secret sauces.
I'm Tim Laird with Kevin Harned. And Tim, today's catch of the day comes with all the secrets to making some great Italian-inspired seafood at home.
Secret.
The twist on a crab cake, it is not seared in a pan. Real simple.
It's Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs in front of a live studio audience, and it starts right now. Hi, everybody, and welcome in to Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. I'm Kevin Harned, along with broadcast partner Tim Laird, and here we are at our kitchen theater in Paristown.
And I'll tell you what, it's a great day to be in the theater, especially if you're a fan of fresh seafood like me. Because this time, Chef Seth Butkus is joining us from Osteria, a restaurant in Louisville's Westport Village that puts an Italian twist on some of the freshest fish you'll find anywhere. In fact, the seafood makes it from the water to your table in 48 hours or less.
Well, and Tim, the pasta is fresh too. It's made in-house every day. We're going to get a taste of that in the chef's Cipino Fettuccine coming up. Plus, the secrets to lump crab cakes that are to die for.
I can't wait, so let's get cooking.
Will you help us welcome to our kitchen theater, Seth Butkus from Osteria.
How's it going, guys?
Good, how are you?
Good to be here.
Well, it's great to have you here, and what an audience. They are all hungry, by the way.
Oh, hello, everybody.
I'll tell you. And how great is it? What a great restaurant, right? I'd say it's a beautiful space. We saw it. You've got these unbelievable murals on the wall that you had hand-painted, right?
Mm-hmm. One of them was done by our kitchen guy. He's a super, super talented artist, and he hand-drew all these different fish, vegetables, herbs on like a chalkboard wall. It looks amazing. And there's another big octopus that's been painted on the wall. It looks fantastic in the restaurant.
Yeah, it really is a neat space that a lot of folks are familiar with because it was the old Napa. So folks that know Westport Village know where they're located. What are we making today, Chef?
So we're going to start with the lump crab cake.
Okay.
It's a little bit of a twist on a crab cake. It is not seared in a pan. It's baked in an oven.
Okay.
Like nothing crazy. It is pure crab. It is 95% crab. So you have the crab. Real simple. Crack an egg.
Whisk it up a little.
How it mixes, yep. Nice whisk. And then, incidentally, in the same container, we will take a little bit of our sofrito. Sofrito is very common in Italian cooking. It is, in the French call it mirepoix, Italians call it sofrito. So onions, celery, carrot, garlic, cooked down, smooth, like real slow, caramelized.
Sofrito, not some Fritos. It's different.
Yeah. And
it's different.
And it's different than the Latin version of sofrito. It's spelled slightly different. Just mix that up. You're gonna pour it in. This is kind of the binder, if you will, to keep it from just flaking apart and falling apart.
Beautiful.
So real simple. I'll sprinkle some chives in here at the end.
Beautiful.
And again, we're not trying to overmix it or overwork it. Real gentle in this ring mold here. Gently kind of pushing it in, not pushing hard, not pushing aggressive, just doing like that. This is where we'll do the lemon aioli, and we're really only going to use a little bit, and this is just to help the breadcrumbs adhere on the top.
Oh, it's like a little glue agent. That's what that's going to be.
Then this is where you finish it off, basically, and you just a little bit, just enough to make like a little crust on top.
And this, again, you're not overpowering the crab, because again, that's gonna be the star of this show, besides Kevin. But you don't wanna overpower that crab, because it's so good, but adds a little crunch factor. So there's the secret, the
right.
Ritz cracker.
Okay.
Ritz.
So, not a seared crab cake. If we are baking it, but we use a 500 degree oven again, and it goes for about 8 to 10 minutes.
Mm, okay.
So very, very quick. So garnish for this, we have a dill sauce. This is one of those secret sauces that I had to work very hard to get from my fiance's grandmother.
We'll call it Gale's Dill Sauce. Sour cream, mayonnaise, dill, accent seasoning, Lowry's seasoning, and a couple other things that if I did tell you, I would get in trouble for. So at this point, hot pan. Don't be silly like I am right now. Maybe use tongs and a towel. And this will pop right out just like that.
Look at that. That is beautiful. Steam. Look at the steam pulling off that. Oh, that looks great, Chef. Awesome.
So, arugula salad. A little bit of this, just tuck it in. Little vegetation, keep it healthy.
Nice
to go
crunch.
With all the you know, all the unhealthy stuff there in your crab cake. And that's about it. I'm gonna try and get a
beautiful
couple
presentation.
More of these little flowers on top, and
that's it. Boom.
Easy money.
How about that? From Chef Seth Butkus, there you have it. Hey, but that's not all, right? Chef, what do we have coming up?
Next, after this, it's the Osteria Cioppino with fettuccine pasta.
Ooh, does that sound good to anybody? We've got more secrets coming from the kitchen at Osteria when we come back on Secrets of Bluegrass Chef. Stay with us, everybody.
Find the highest quality seafood anywhere in town at Highland Fish Market in Middletown. From snow crab to smoked salmon, handmade crab cakes to halibut, our seafood comes in fresh every day. And we have a wide array of seasonings, artisan olive oils, and balsamic vinegars too.
Right now, save big on cooked shrimp. Buy 1 pound and get a second at half off.
Order yours today in store or online at highlandfish.com. Find out how fresh seafood can be at Highland Fish Market in Middletown.
Dine Company, the restaurant store, is one of Louisville's hidden gems. Located on Preston Highway, you'll find more than 30,000 square feet of retail space that's open to restaurants and residential customers. No membership required. Shop catering and bar supplies, cookware, utensils, and more in-store or online at dinecompany.com. Experience the difference our knowledge and services make. Dine Company, family-owned and operated since 1982.
Tim Laird back with you on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs, and it's time now to head out on the cocktail tour.
This time, we're in Louisville at Lulu on Market, which is a lot like New Orleans.
Lulu is from Louisville, Louisiana.
They're serving authentic Creole cooking in an atmosphere that feels like Mardi Gras every day. And downstairs at the bar they call the Stave, Beckman keeps the party cooking with an array of creative cocktails like this one. His pecan old fashioned. He's sharing the secrets to that one right now.
We're gonna cut up a little bit of jalapeno. So with the jalapenos gone down there, we're also gonna take a little bit of this Demerara simple syrup. I made this last night with a little bit of cinnamon and a little bit of apple butter, just a little bit. I know it's kind of sweet, but it's got a lot of nice dense flavors in there. So we're gonna break down this jalapeno. We're gonna make sure that we're gonna leave it in there with some Monk's Road. 6 year single barrel, 100 proof. We just poured 2 ounces of that in there. We're gonna take our little rocks. Bourbon should never be shaken. It's too delicate. The monks knew that down there in the monastery. So we're just gonna give it a good whirlwind. We're gonna stir it. We're going to decant into our glass. You can see the jalapenos there, adding some wonderful flavor at the end. We bring you some Hellfire Bitters because an old fashioned needs to have just a little bit of kick to it, as this one does. And I'm gonna give you a little citrus at the end there. Come on down to the Stave, people. Get yourself a Monk's Road pecan old fashioned and enjoy. Back to you, Timmy.
Cheers, Beckman, and stick around because we have more Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs coming up.
The Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs Cocktail Tour is presented by The Amp at Log Still Distillery.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. I'm Kevin Harned. I've made my way over to the PNC Bank tasting table. Virginia's going to have a chance to take a taste. In fact, it appears you already have.
You
beat me to it.
Yeah.
Well, and that's what I want to talk about because, you know, oftentimes, and you say you're a fan of sort of that Italian-inspired seafood.
Yes.
And crab cakes happen to be one of my favorite seafoods if I'm going to have it. Sometimes on that menu, you do find that you bite into it and it's nothing but just bread, and you struggle to find even a bite of the crab. So I'm curious to hear what you thought of Seth's crab cake.
I thought it was the perfect crab cake. Everything that I would imagine a crab cake to be. It wasn't too much breading. It was perfect amount of crab. And I like the lemon zest and the
sauce. So you could taste
it. I could taste the lemon zest. I could taste a lot of the citrus. I think it's really good. Perfect crab cake.
And a nice generous portion too, which I like.
Very generous. I like the greenery around it and the homemade secret grandma's recipe.
Yeah, Gail's dill sauce. Yeah.
Very good.
Well, we appreciate you guys being here.
Thank you so much.
Hope you enjoy the rest of the show. We're not finished. Seth Butkus from Osteria is coming back up. He's got some cioppino, and we can't wait to hear the secrets of that when we come back on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. How do you like that?
If you like Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs on TV, you'll love to see it in person.
Great time.
Fabulous.
Join us at the Secrets Kitchen Theater in Louisville's historic Paris Town.
This is a great experience.
I love that.
Watch top chefs reveal their secrets.
And I don't really hold back on this stuff.
And then taste everything they make.
I love this.
Delicious.
You can also enjoy all the other fun and shopping Paris Town has to offer while you're there.
We had a really good time.
Get your tickets now online at mintjuleptours.com. And hurry, because space is limited.
This is so good and so popular.
Watch Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs on TV and see it in person by going to mintjuleptours.com.
It was outstanding.
Make your reservations today.
Still cooking.
Appreciate you sharing the secrets.
Savor seasonal food and fine wine on Frankfort Avenue at Veronese with live jazz 7 days a week. Cocktails, dinner, and private events. Late night dining, too. The place to be is at the V. Veronese on Frankfort Avenue.
Kevin Harned back with you on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs, and right now it's time for another Wine Find with John Johnson at the Wine Rack.
This time, we'd like to introduce an ancient category of wine that was long forgotten and is now new again. And that is the category of orange wine. It's an exciting wine category that many people think will be the fourth category of wine, in addition to white wine, red wine, and rosé. Orange wine, first and foremost, is not made from oranges. There's no orange fruit used in the production of these beautiful wines. How the wine is made is you're making a wine from grapes that are typically used for white wine, but making it in the method that is normally reserved for red wine. So after they crush the grapes, they leave the juice in contact with the skins for anywhere from a few days to several weeks. The longer it's in contact with those skins, the more color it's going to extract and the deeper that orange hue. Very interesting category of wine, and in my opinion, a category of wine that goes best with food. The first one that I want to show you this evening is one from Gerard Bertrand. Gerard Bertrand is one of our favorite producers in the south of France. Former rugby star, plowed all his endorsement money into the family winery and took it over from his dad when he retired from rugby. This wine is made from a combination of Chardonnay grapes, along with Viognier, Chenin Blanc, Grenache Blanc, and Roussan. It is an amazing wine to have with seafood, in particular things like scallops, shrimp. Also crazy good with spicy Asian food, whether you're talking Thai, Chinese, or what have you. The other wine, another orange wine, but this one is a little bit lighter. This is from our friends at Bonnie Dune, one of the first winemakers in California to use grapes that were native to the Rhone and not from Bordeaux or Burgundy. So things like Syrah, Grenache, etc. It's a little lighter in color and body than the Gerard Bertrand. Great salad wine, also great with any kind of cold cuts, and seafood as well. Check out this exciting emerging category of wine and all the interesting wines we have from around the world. Cheers.
Thanks, John. Stick around. We have more Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs coming up.
The Wine Rack, bringing you wines, beers, spirits, and cheeses of the world for over 18 years. Local, independent, and now offering delivery from the heart of Crescent Hill. and online at wineshoplouisville.com.
Stop chasing your dog with a toothbrush. Use Pet Silver Teeth and Gum Spray, the natural solution for your pet's oral health and funky pet breath. Get Pet Silver online at petsilver.com.
Italian at its finest. Volare. Inspired cuisine by Chef Josh Moore. Intimate dining, private events, and year-round patio seating. Savor Volare. Cocktails and dinner 7 nights a week. Volare on Frankfort Avenue.
Tim Laird back with you on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs in our kitchen theater at Paristown. Paristown has become a real hotspot these days for food and fun with festivals, flea markets, and our Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs kitchen theater, where today we're cooking fresh seafood in front of a live studio audience.
Yes, we are. In fact, you've got him here right in front of you. This is Chef Seth Butkus from Osteria, and he has made that awesome crab cake. Virginia thought it was good. How about you guys?
Wow. It's nice. A winner.
It's a winner. We are making fresh seafood and back with another incredible dish that is Italian sort of inspired. Happens to be the twist on cioppino. This is cioppino fettuccine, you call it.
Right. So traditionally it would be a stew. We just felt like throwing some pasta in it. And honestly, it came out as an awesome dish.
Yeah.
So, you know, it worked out great.
I like that
awesome
idea.
And I love cioppino.
Oh, I do. You do too, yeah. I mean, yeah. It's usually the fishing, Italian fishing markets,
yeah,
that everybody would bring something to put in the stew.
Yep.
But I love that you're actually adding a little fettuccine in there.
Yeah, and you know, we're making tons of fresh pasta in the restaurant as it is, so why not?
Well, there's sort of no rules with cioppino anyway, right?
Like, yeah, it could be any number of, I mean, there's no limit to how many seafoods you can put in or should put in.
Right.
You know, it's an umbrella dish for you.
No wonder I like it.
Kind of take it and have some fun with it.
Whatever you want to chip in. And again, you make all your pastas fresh. This is it. Nothing out of a box.
Nothing out of a box. It's truly, truly a labor of love. And these are sheets that we make. And I will roll these up to cut a fettuccine noodle out of.
That's beautiful, too.
Like, yeah, look at that.
Nice and thin.
Absolutely super, gorgeous. Super thin. Now that you have it like this, if you wanted to cut pappardelle, you could cut thick noodles. You know, we're going to cut fettuccines roughly 1/4 inch, give or take. And this is how we do it in the restaurant, hand cut them. If we wanted to do something thinner, you know, obviously we can cut whatever we want out of these. So for this particular pasta, this will probably be more than we need, but it's always better to have a little bit more than not enough.
By the way, that was you didn't use any measurement device. That was actually perfectly cut.
and you know, I like because it's handmade, I like doing it like this. And I like the little bits of imperfections. It shows that it is a hand-cut pasta. I'm not going to even do anything with it yet. So we're going to go back. Like I said, we're going to start with our seafood here. And you need to cook these things somewhat individually. You can sort of do them all together, but they do have different cook times. So you want to be mindful. It depends on how big your pans are at home, how hot your stove is. This one seems like it's doing perfectly fine.
Getting there.
Nice and hot.
Yes. A little bit of oil. Again, this is that citrus-infused oil, which is very nice with the seafood. And we'll get hot pan. Sir, get me rolling around.
That's a good sear right there. Boom.
The pan is smoking. Don't be afraid.
And the seafood that you have takes no time to cook. It's so quick.
Right.
Yeah, these, I mean, you know, to do them proper, maybe 2 minutes aside.
Right.
Maybe. And then just take them out of the pan, let them rest. They'll carry over. They'll be perfect.
So
pretty much every time.
So many people do it wrong and they get chewy.
Yeah.
Best.
Take your time with it. But also don't take too much time. Like don't rush it. You know, you're looking at it, I'm looking at it now. Make sure the color is good. Once you have the color, you can kind of start to mitigate that time. I'm gonna start adding these clams in because they are actually the things that will take the most time. We'll add them in just like that. And I'm really just looking for this color on the scallops. And we're only gonna cook them through really on one side because we will finish them back into the sauce.
Now Tim's being shy. The best scallops I ever had was at Tim's house.
Yeah, I love scallops.
You
it really
made
is.
Excellent
and,
scallops.
And the key is, like where you're sourcing them, you want them fresh, you want them delicious. And I'll tell you, when you get them that fresh, you don't even have to cook them. You can eat them raw safely. But you know what? I love a little sear on that, just like that. That mm-hmm. looks great, Chef.
These right now, they're fairly cooked. And like I said, I'm going to pull them out because I'm going to finish them in the pan. I have those
mussels.
Clams cooking. Now I'll add the mussels, and I will go ahead and add the shrimp. Shrimp will cook very, very fast. The mussels will cook fast, and by the time I add this wine,
and what's nice about it,
things will start to be popping open.
Are going to add a little flavor to the other. So as they mingle together in that pan, they're sharing their juices, their flavors.
And really, at this point, these just getting a little color. I'm going to hit this white wine in here. That steam should get our clams, our mussels, all that stuff going. It's going to help that juice from the shrimp kind of seep into it. That'll be the base for our sauce. Once it reduces down a little, I will add some of the sofrito, this tomato sauce here that's like a little bit spicy, a little bit of the garlic, and I'll garnish with these herbs here. I'm going to go ahead and drop this pasta. You can cook pasta like this.
Well, Chef, while that's cooking, stay with us. We're going to come back and we're going to see the amazing plate up of this cappuccino with fettuccine. Oh, all right, stay with us on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs.
River House Restaurant and Raw Bar, now open for lunch and dinner 7 days a week, featuring the cuisine of Chef John Veronese with a Southern-inspired menu and an emphasis on seafood with a spectacular raw bar. River House, right next to the water tower at 3015 River Road. Reservations recommended.
Make food service easier with help from Dine Company, the restaurant store. If you prep, cook, or serve food, Dine serves you. Shop Louisville's largest selection of new and used food equipment and small wares in-store or online at dinecompany.com. Experience the difference our knowledge and services make. Dine Company, family-owned and operated since 1982.
At Ditto's, there's an open kitchen that lets you know something fabulous is cooking, like our sizzling stacked ribeye or raspberry chicken salad. Ditto's Grill, delightful, delectable, delicious. It's gotta be Ditto's. Bardstown Road at Grinstead Drive.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. Kevin Harned, Tim Laird, Seth Butkus from Osteria here. We're making and putting the final touches on the cappuccino fettuccine. Always easy to tell when mussels and clams are finished.
They open up and they say, we're done. You know, and that's the secret to this dish is the fresh seafood that you're getting, like you said, because of UPS. But, you know, for those folks at home, there's a place called Highland Fish Market in Middletown that has great, that's where I get my scallops because I like to eat it raw and I know they're all always fresh, fresh, fresh. Secret to any dish
matters.
So now, we'll start finishing up our sauce here. A little bit of sofrito.
And again, the flavor is all right there.
Yep,
all so much of it.
All that seafood juice is in there. You notice I haven't done anything with the lobster yet. That's going to basically poach in this sauce here last second.
Doesn't take long.
Does not take long. And that.
And talk about the spice. You said that was a little spicy. So what is in that?
So marinara.
But what'd you put in it to make it spicy?
Just crushed red pepper.
Easy enough.
Yep, super simple. Actually, we can just do like this. Transfer the pan. And we are moments away from plating. We have this pasta going down.
That looks delicious.
And this is where, like I said, I will add all of our seafoods back in. Get the heat back into them.
Doesn't that look good?
Coat them in the sauce.
Oh, they're gonna pick up a little of the flavor of the sauce.
Mm-hmm. Make sure you get all that extra stuff on top, and then we'll plate all this stuff right on top.
So that just goes on top, just so you know what you're getting. Boom.
Yep, and we'll, you know, sort of try and artfully do it, but, you know, it's pasta. You can only make it so fancy.
Plus, that's a beautiful presentation that way.
And then we'll get, yep, get the clams.
Oh, look at that. In fact, I don't want chupino without the fettuccine from here on out. Boom.
Yeah, we're going to strike.
You know, it's kind of like you dig into this, you see this great pasta or this all the seafood, then underneath,
perfect.
Ooh, that fresh fettuccine.
All right, then this is pretty common technique. If you haven't heard of a chiffonade of basil, you just take the leaves and roll them up, and we're going to cut little ribbons. I'm going to try and go pretty thin.
Wow, that is a thin cut, but that's great, Chef.
Fancy.
Fluff it a little. Just a little sprinkle on top.
That
like
smells
such.
Good.
Yeah, you get that fresh herb flavor in there, some chives. Same thing. And then just
gotta have some of that citrus olive oil.
Some of that citrus olive oil. Bang, there it is.
Boom, there it is. Look at that.
Wow.
Fettuccine. Chipino.
Sounds delicious. We appreciate you sharing the secrets today.
Oh, awesome.
For folks that are looking to find you, I mentioned sort of it was in Westport Village, but tell them the address, let them know how to get there, what they can expect if they come in.
Well, you can expect to have a good meal, great service, great wines, great, great cocktails. The address, 1211 Her Lane. It's in Linden. If you find the Westport Village, we're smack in the middle of it, basically.
Yeah, easy to find. Easy to find, but tough to get into, meaning you need reservations because you are slammed.
Yeah, definitely don't try and just wing it. It's like definitely plan, try and call, get on online, however you gotta do it, get a reservation because it's really busy right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
great.
It's because it's good. Everybody have fun today. Yeah. Seth, it's time for us to say goodbye, so thank you.
Thanks, Chef. Awesome job, buddy.
Awesome.
We hope everybody had a good time. If you'd like to be a member of our studio audience, it's easy to do. Simply log on to mintjuleptours.com. For Tim Laird, I'm Kevin Harned. We'll see you next time on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs.
Find the highest quality seafood anywhere in town at Highland Fish Market in Middletown. From snow crab to smoked salmon, handmade crab cakes to halibut, our seafood comes in fresh every day. And we have a wide array of seasonings, artisan olive oils, and balsamic vinegar stew. Find out how fresh seafood can be at Highland Fish Market in Middletown.
See the best of Kentucky in Nashville, Tennessee with Mint Julep Experiences, the local leader in Southern luxury travel. Get exclusive access to bourbon and whiskey distilleries, elevated culinary and mixology experiences, private barrel selections, and much more. Let our team take the hassle and worry out of your trip planning with our dedicated experts handling the curation of the entire itinerary and transportation. The purpose of fun is to have some. From Bourbon City to Music City, come immerse yourself with Mint Julep Experiences.
Authentic Mexican cuisine at Gustavo's with 5 locations, including one on Hurstbourne Parkway. It's food that goes way beyond burritos and tacos, with everything from sizzling fajitas to seafood. The bar is stocked with bourbon and one of the best selections of tequila in the area, and Gustavo's own Vida de Reyes Mexican lager with a hint of jalapeno. Taste and feel the authenticity at Gustavo's Mexican Grill in Crestwood, LaGrange, Prospect, Norton Commons, and now on Hurstbourne. Open every day for lunch and dinner. Gustavo's Mexican Grill.
Originally in Tribeca, New York City, Rock is now in Louisville. Rock offers homemade and fresh quality food with an extensive wine and bourbon list. I will ensure that your Italian experience will be memorable. Rock on Barstown Road. Ciao, a presto.
Olive oil is an essential part of a healthy, low-cholesterol diet, and it comes in all flavors at Z Olive, home to the finest extra virgin olive oils from around the world. And you can try all of them before you buy. Z Olive also has a wide variety of fine balsamic vinegars. Great low-cal flavorings for everything from ice cream to steaks, marinades, and glazes. Z Olive makes the perfect gift, or make it your secret ingredient. Taste the finest at Z Olive in Westport Village.